Good morning, my dear cutie pies. This is Kritika Paliwal welcoming you again in the English grammar class. So we were studying the noun and kinds of noun. Okay, so I had told you about three kinds of noun. The proper noun, the common noun, and the collective noun. Okay, so these three types we had discussed about in our previous lectures. So, proper noun is what? It is the name of person, places, animals, of thing, of. These are the special names. Okay, I'm just recalling it one more time. Proper nouns are the special names. Okay, individual names. Like the name of the monument Taj Mahal. Okay. This is a proper noun and we will always write it, we will always write the first letter capital, okay? Then the common noun. Common nouns are the names of the person, places, animals or things of the same kind, okay? Of the same kind means like I write animals, okay? Animal. So this word is a common noun because there are so many animals in the world. Then collective nouns. Okay, so I had told you that we will discuss more about the collective nouns in today's lecture. So we are going to discuss about it in a little bit detail. So collective nouns, as per the definition given in your book, what is a collective noun in your book? Your book says that a collective nouns are the words for groups of people, animals or things. Collective nouns are the words. These are the words, or if I say names, of what? Of groups of people. Of groups. Okay, this word is important here. Groups of people, animal or things. Okay, these are what? Collective nouns are what? These are the words or names of the groups. Names of the groups, I am repeating. Groups of what? The people, animal or thing. Okay, then there are some examples given in your book. So let's have a look at that example, and after that I'll tell you some more examples that are not in your book. So the first example that is given in your book is of army. Now army is what? It is a collective noun. It is a collective noun. Okay, now what group it represents? It represents the group of soldiers. It represents the group of soldiers. Do you know what are soldiers? Who are soldiers? Who are soldiers? They are the ones protecting us on the boundaries of our nation. Jo sainik hote hain, those are called soldiers. Okay, and they are the most important for us because they all protect us. They stand at the boundaries. They take the gun on their own chest. Okay, they take the bullet on their own chest just to protect us. Okay, so the soldiers are the most important members or most important ones of our country. So army is what? It represents the group of soldiers. What is an army? It represents the group of soldiers. Then secondly, I had told you in the previous lecture also, bouquet. B-O-U-Q-U-E-T, bouquet. What is a bouquet? इसे बुकेट नहीं पढ़ेंगे हम. We will read it as bouquet. So what is a bouquet? Bouquet is a group of flowers. Okay, group of flowers. जब बहुत सारे flowers हम एक साथ we collect them and just we wrap it and make a good bouquet. Okay, we make the we combine the group of flowers. Then what we got? What we get? We get a bouquet there. Okay, then just a sec. Then bunch. What is a bunch? It is group of keys. Okay, when we collect so many keys, key you know na chabiyan. Okay, keys, what are keys? Jo chabiyan hoti jisse hum lock kholte hain. Okay, so when we just make a group of all the keys, aisa aapne dekha hoga your mama doing this. So that घर की सारी keys ऐसे खो ना जाए, so they, your grandmother, your mama make them they just collect all the keys and make a bunch of the keys so that the keys will not get lost. Okay, so that what the collection, the group of keys, what we call them bunch. Okay, what we call them bunch. So what is a bunch? It is a group of keys. So this word bunch is what? What type of noun? It is a collective noun. Okay, then moving forward, just a second. Then moving forward, what we get? Then next, fleet. Fleet. What is a fleet? This word is also a collective noun. And what is a fleet? It is a group of ships. Group of ships. These ships I am talking about. Wo ship nahi, wo bhed wala ship nahi. That has a different spelling. S-H-E-E-P-C. S-H-E-E-P-C. This sheep is a bhed. Okay, bhed wala sheep. That cattle. But this ships, group of ships moving in water. So one ship is called a ship. But when we have a group of ships, when there are so many ships, what we call that group? We call that group a fleet. Okay, what we call that group? We call that group a fleet. So what is a fleet? This is a collective noun that represents a group of ships. Okay, then next is a flock. Next is what? A flock. So what does a flock represents? A group of birds. Okay, what does a flock represent? It represents a group of birds. Okay, so what, whenever you will see a group of birds flying in the sky, what you will call them? That a flock of bird is flying there. What you will say? A flock of bird is flying there. Okay, so group of birds is called what? It is called a flock. So what is this word? This word is a collective noun. Flock. Ye word kya hai? Ye collective noun hai. Okay, इधर से कुछ भी collective noun नहीं है. This word is a collective noun. Then herd. Herd. This is also again a collective noun. And what does this collective noun represents? This represents a group of cattle. Group of cattle. C-A-T-T-L-E. Now what is cattle? Cattle kya hote hai? Domestic animals hote hai na? Like cow, cow, buffalo, goat. So when these all come in a group, जब वो पूरे एक ग्रुप में होते हैं, so we call them cattle, okay? So what is cattle? What is the group of cattle called? Herd. So आपने देखा होगा, whenever you will go in a village, okay? Here in our city, we can't see that. But whenever we go in a village, जब हम किसी गांव में जाकर देखते हैं, so what do we see? There we see a group of so many animals roaming. And what are those animals? These are the domestic animals. Domestic animals like cows, goats, buffalo, जब वो एक पूरा group में जाते हैं, so एक साथ group जाता है आप अगर when you if you go to a village in your holidays, you will see there. So that group is called what? This group is called a herd. The group of cattle is called a herd. Okay, then now school. अब आप सोचेंगे हमारा स्कूल गोकुलदास पब्लिक स्कूल the place where the children studies, not that type of school. Okay, this school is different. The गोकुलदास पब्लिक स्कूल जो जहाँ हम पढ़ते हैं, that is not a collective noun. But this is what it is, a group of fishes swimming together. It is a group of just a second, fish. Group of fish or fishes swimming together. अच्छा आपने डिस्कवरी चैनल पर देखा होगा, जस्ट अ मिनट बेटा, या बोर्ड इज विजिबल। हाँ सो इफ यू, अगर आप कार्टून चैनल्स के अलावा भी कोई चैनल्स देखते हैं, सो इफ यू वॉच डिस्कवरी चैनल, वहाँ पर ना दे शो अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स, दे शो द फॉरेस्ट, दे शो द सीज, ओशंस। तो जब वो सी समुद्र दिखाते हैं वहाँ पर, व्हाट दे शो, दे शो दैट सो मेनी फिशेस आर स्विमिंग टुगेदर, बहुत सारे फिशेस एक साथ तैर रही होती है। सो व्हाट वी कॉल दैट ग्रुप, उन फिशेस के ग्रुप को हम क्या बोलते हैं, वी कॉल दैट ग्रुप अ स्कूल। ओके सो दिस स्कूल इज डिफरेंट वेयर वी स्टडी, एंड दिस स्कूल इट इज अ कलेक्टिव नाउन। व्हाट इज दिस स्कूल, इट इज अ कलेक्टिव नाउन। ओके सो दिस स्कूल इज डिफरेंट, सो देयर आर टू स्कूल्स, ओके विद द सेम स्पेलिंग, वन वेयर वी स्टडी, एक स्कूल जहां हम पढ़ते हैं, ठीक है, दैट इज डिफरेंट। द अदर स्कूल दैट इज अ कलेक्टिव नाउन, इट इज, इट रिप्रेजेंट्स अ ग्रुप ऑफ फिशेस स्विमिंग टुगेदर। ओके व्हाट डज इट रिप्रेजेंट, it represent group of fish swimming together. Then next is a team, group of players, okay. So team is what, it is a group of players. जब बहुत देखो एक player अकेला खड़ा है तो वो हम player ही बोलेंगे, but when there are so many players playing together, we call that those players a team. Group of players क्या होते हैं? What do we call group of players? Players खिलाड़ी. Okay, so what do we call them? A team. Just like our Indian cricket team, they are so many players ना? Individually they are players, but when they come together, they form a team. And what is that? Our Indian cricket team. Okay, so I guess these are the ones given in your book. अब कुछ जो है वो थोड़े एक्स्ट्रा है वो हम और देख लेते हैं, सम कलेक्टिव नाउन्स दैट आर नॉट इन योर बुक। ओके जस्ट गिव मी अ सेकंड। सो लाइक ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल, I have told you, I think if you remember in the previous lecture also I had told you, जब बहुत सारे लोग एक जगह इकट्ठा होते हैं, जब बहुत सारे लोगों का ग्रुप होता है तो we call that group of people a crowd. Crowd मतलब भीड़, okay? We call that a crowd ना, right? And whenever you go to the market, you see a crowd of people. Okay, so this word crowd is what? It is a collective noun. It is what? It's a collective noun. Then group of musicians. Then group of musicians. जब बहुत सारे musicians एक group में होते हैं, जैसे if someone is playing a piano, if someone is playing a guitar, if someone is playing a flute, if someone is just beating the drums, so we call what we call that group, we call that group a band. So a band of musicians, not a group of musicians, what we call, then we call it a band. So this word band is what, it's a collective noun, it represents what, ye kya represent kar raha hai, ye represent kar raha hai ki yes there are a group, there is a group of people, there is a group of musicians jo music play kar rahe hain. Okay, then next is group of students like you. So what do you form when you sit in a group in a room? So what we call you, we call you a class. Okay, so group of students is a class, so this word class is also a collective noun. Okay, then यू माइट हैव सीन सम एंट्स देयर इन योर हाउस, आपके घर में आपने चींटियां जरूर देखी होगी, है ना? इन दिस रेनी सीजन द चींटियां एंड द मकोड़ेस आर जस्ट कम आउट फ्रॉम देयर होल्स, ओके? सो एंड दे जस्ट गो इन अ प्रॉपर डिसिप्लिंड लाइन इफ यू नोटिस, ओके? वो हम इंसानों से भी ज्यादा डिसिप्लिन चलते हैं, ठीक है? सो उनका जो ग्रुप होता है, व्हाट वी कॉल देम अ आर्मी, सॉरी एन आर्मी, ठीक है? वी कॉल देम एन आर्मी. सो ग्रुप ऑफ एंट्स, जो चींटियां होती है उनके ग्रुप को हम क्या बोलते हैं? आर्मी. ओके, सो देयर आर टू वर्ड्स दैट रिप्रेजेंट, सॉरी द सिंगल वर्ड रिप्रेजेंट्स टू ग्रुप्स. आर्मी रिप्रेजेंट्स द ग्रुप ऑफ सोल्जर्स ऑल्सो, एंड आर्मी रिप्रेजेंट्स द ग्रुप ऑफ एंट्स ऑल्सो. अब ग्रुप ऑफ एंट्स को आर्मी ही क्यों बोला? Why we call group of ants army? You know why? Because the ants, the cheetia, okay? They move just the same way the army soldiers move. Army soldiers भी आपने जब भी देखा होगा, they move in a proper line, okay? The same way all the cheetias move in a proper line, जैसे बिल्कुल disciplined way में, okay? So a group of ants is called an army. The next is a group of dancers. अच्छा, dancers होते हैं, and what when dancers come together and they just perform in a group, what we call that group? Think, we what we call that group? We call that group a troupe. We call that group a troop. Okay, we call that group a troop. So a group of dancers is called a troop. And what is this word? This word is a collective noun. What is this? It's a collective noun. So a group of ants is called an army, and a group of dancers is called a troop. Then a group of thieves. Okay, what do we call a group of thieves? जब बहुत सारे चोर, thieves मतलब चोर, okay? जब वो चोर ऐसे ग्रुप में चोरी करते हैं, मतलब उनके ग्रुप को हम क्या बोलते हैं? We call that group a gang. Okay, so a gang of thieves. A gang of thieves. आपने सुना होगा इंडियन मूवीज में, हाँ इनका गैंग है. So that gang represents what? The group of thieves is called a gang. Okay, so I guess these are so many other collective nouns that I had told you from my side, other than the book. Apart from book, I have told you so many other collective nouns. Now I guess these three types of nouns are clear to you. The three types of nouns, the proper noun, common noun and the collective noun. Okay, और noun का ये जो सिलसिला है ये यहाँ ख़त्म नहीं होता है. Noun को आपको lifetime पढ़ना है. Okay, so in class 2 you have studied now. We will discuss it in much later when we solve the exercise. जब हम exercise करेंगे, अभी just हम करने वाले हैं, तो जब हम exercise करेंगे noun और clear हो जाएंगे. फिर then you will study noun in the class 3, class 4, class 5, class 6 and so on. Okay, so if you have not understood, that's okay. When we will solve the exercise, we will get to know more about the nouns. So I just want you to open page number 21 of your fancy book. Open page 21 of fancy. Okay beta, just open it fast. Open page 21 of your fancy book. We are going to solve the exercise. And yeah, your homework to do that I have told you in the previous lecture also. 5 common nouns, 5 proper nouns. Now today I have explained the collective nouns clearly. So you have to write 5 collective nouns. और ऐसा नहीं कि बस लिख दिया army और herd और flock और fleet, इस तरह से आप पूरा लिखेंगे. A group of ants is called an army. Group of soldiers is called an army. Group of swimming fishes is called a school, like that. Okay? Just you can take the help of lecture also. So the first question that is given on page number 21, question number 8. I am reading the question for you. Write the noun. Acha, have you sharpened your pencils? Just sharp your pencil fast. Write the noun which is different from the others in these list. Abhi humko yahan pe list diya hai, udhar bahut sare nouns diye hain, but we have to just pick out a different noun. Humko us group mein se ek अलग टाइप का नाउन, उसको बस निकाल कर साइड में लिखना है, ठीक है? सो जस्ट आई एम टेलिंग यू, फर्स्ट वन रेड ब्लू कलर येलो देन ग्रीन एंड यू आर गिवन अ स्पेस हियर, लेट मी जस्ट चेक इट इज विजिबल और नॉट, जस्ट अ मोमेंट, हाँ इट इज विजिबल. So see, you are given all these are nouns. Now these represent all common nouns. Red, blue, green. Red, blue, color, yellow, green. Red is also a common noun. अच्छा अब आप बोलेंगे कि red तो एक particular color का नाम है. But we don't have only one red color. Red color, there are so many red colors in the world. दुनिया में एक ही जगह पर तो red color नहीं है. दुनिया में पूरी मतलब बहुत सारी जगहों पर red color है, right? So that red color is a common noun. Now रेड ब्लू येलो ग्रीन ऑल दीज आर व्हाट, इसको छोड़ो, रेड ब्लू येलो ग्रीन ऑल दीज आर व्हाट कलर्स, ओके ऑल दीज आर व्हाट कलर्स, बट दिस वर्ड कलर इज डिफरेंट देन दिस, मतलब इट इज नॉट दैट मच डिफरेंट, बट इट इज नॉट गेटिंग फिट इन दिस ग्रुप, ये इस ग्रुप में फिट नहीं हो रहा है, दैट्स व्हाई दिस वर्ड कलर इज अ डिफरेंट वर्ड, दैट्स व्हाई वी आर पिकिंग इट आउट, ओके देन सेकंडली potato, vegetable, cauliflower, then brinjal and capsicum. I'm writing it down, okay? Okay, so all these are what? See, potato is a vegetable. Vegetable word is not a vegetable. It is a noun that represents the vegetables. Okay, so this vegetable word is not a vegetable, but it represents the vegetables. Okay, potato is a vegetable. Leave it. Cauliflower is a vegetable. Cauliflower, what we call it in Hindi, phoolgobi. Okay, then brinjal, bangan. Okay, then capsicum. कैप्सिकम इज द थिंग दैट शिनचैन डजंट लाइक टू ईट, कैप्सिकम शिनचैन को बिल्कुल पसंद नहीं, वॉट इज दैट ग्रीन वेजिटेबल, आई एम फॉरगेटिंग द हिंदी नेम ऑफ इट, सॉरी कैप्सिकम, ओके सो ऑल दीज आर वॉट, दीज आर ऑल वेजिटेबल्स, बट दिस वर्ड वेजिटेबल इज नॉट अ वेजिटेबल, ये इन सभी को हम वेजिटेबल बोलते हैं, ओके बट दिस वर्ड इज नॉट अ वेजिटेबल, सो दैट्स वाई इट इज डिफरेंट एंड वी आर राइटिंग इट हियर, वेजिटेबल. Okay, then third one, lion, tiger, wolf, buffalo, and animal. Okay, now I know आप इतने स्मार्ट हो गए हैं कि आप इसमें से खुद ही निकाल लिया होगा जो डिफरेंट नाउन है वो. Now let us give it a check. Lion, it's a noun, but it's the name of an animal. Tiger, it's a noun, it's the name of an animal. Wolf is also an animal. Buffalo is also an animal. But this animal word, it is not an animal. We call all the animal. It is the name of those animals. Okay, but this is not an animal. This is a noun that represents the species of animals, the ones we call animals. Okay, so this word animal is different. So I'm writing it here. ओके ऑल दीज आर एनिमल्स, इन सभी के लिए जो वर्ड जो नाउन हम यूज करते हैं वो है एनिमल, ओके सो दिस इज डिफरेंट. देन नंबर फोर, प्लैनेट, वीनस, मर्क्यूरी, जुपिटर एंड सैटर्न. So planet, Venus, Mercury, Jupiter, Saturn. Now I don't know in your EVS syllabus or the planets are covered or not, but I'll give you a little bit information about the planets if the time is remaining. Yes. So what are planets? Our Earth, the planet, the place where we live. मतलब खरगोन नहीं. Okay. हमारा जो पूरा planet है, जो पूरा आपको दिखता है ना एटमॉस्फेयर एंड ऑल दिस इज ऑल कवर्ड इन अर्थ. ओके सो द अर्थ इट इज द प्लेस वेयर वी लिव एंड दैट इज अ प्लैनेट ऑफ अवर सोलर सिस्टम. ओके मैम इज दिस एरिया विजिबल? So you know this is sun and around sun all the planets just move. Our earth also moves like this. Sun ke aas paas gol gol ghoomte. Okay so our earth is on number third. Earth is the third planet. Similarly like earth there are eight other planets. Sorry there are seven other planets. Including earth there are eight planets. Okay so all these are the names of planets. See this Mercury planet it is on the number one in this circle. Okay, this is the smallest, if I say, smallest planet. Okay, then Mercury, Jupiter is the largest planet. Okay, then Saturn, it has rings around it. Ab theek hai, EVS se hum wapas se English mein aate hain. So, you know, this planet, this word represents all these planets. But this Venus, Mercury, Jupiter, Saturn are individual planets, just like Earth. Theek hai? Ab now, if you are noticing, this Venus, V is capital, Mercury, M is capital, Jupiter, J is capital, and in Saturn, S is capital. And I had told you very clearly that we write the first letter of which type of noun capital? We write the first letter of the proper noun capital. So, all these are what? Proper nouns. Ye proper nouns kyu hai? Because Venus ke jaisa dusra planet dunya mein nahi hai, Venus ek hi hai, akela hai. Isliye uska naam jo Venus hai. Theek hai? Ye saare planets hai, but Venus akela मतलब नॉट अकेला. वीनस इज द इंडिविजुअल प्लैनेट ऑफ इट्स काइंड. सो वीनस इज द नेम ऑफ अ प्लैनेट, पर्टिकुलर नेम ऑफ अ प्लैनेट. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज रिटन इन कैपिटल. सिमिलरली मर्क्यूरी इज आल्सो वन प्लैनेट. मर्क्यूरी इज द नेम ऑफ अ प्लैनेट. ठीक है सो दैट्स व्हाई एम इज कैपिटल हियर. सिमिलरली जे इज कैपिटल इन जुपिटर एंड एस इज कैपिटल इन सैटर्न. सो कमिंग बैक टू द क्वेश्चन व्हाट इज डिफरेंट, व्हाट कैन यू सी डिफरेंट इन दिस. All these are proper nouns. This is a common noun. Okay, so we are just putting out the word planet. Then number 5. Apple, papaya, mango, fruit, banana. Papaya. Apple, papaya, mango, fruit and banana. Okay, beta, now you are that much smart to just figure out what is different now. Apple is a fruit, papaya is a fruit, mango is a fruit. This word fruit represents all the other fruits. Okay, this banana is also fruit. So, which is different? This word, fruit. Theek hai? So, see, the time is not remaining much. So, we can cover only this exercise. Just do this exercise in your book and do send me the names of 5 collective nouns as your homework. Okay, so what we had studied in this chapter, we will do the remaining exercise in the next lecture. What we had studied in this lecture is proper noun, common noun and collective noun. I'm just revising it one more time. Okay, just let's revise it one more time. Other exercises we will solve in the next lecture. Examples given in your book. Sanjeev is watching TV. Okay, Sanjeev is watching television. Sanjeev, okay, Sanjeev. So here Sanjeev is the name of a person. Okay, it is the name of a person. It is the name of a boy or a man. So what is this Sanjeev? It is a proper noun. Now, is there any other noun in the sentence? Is a helping verb. Watching is a main verb. Then television is what? It is a common noun. It is a common noun. Okay, क्योंकि दुनिया में बहुत सारे televisions हैं ना, एक ही थोड़ी ना है. हाँ, but if I name a particular company of television like Sony, SONY, Sony company. So this Sony company is one of its kind, individual name of a company which sells television. So this Sony na, Sony TV jo hum likhenge, Sony television. So this Sony word S will be capital. Okay, so this is what a proper noun. So इस टाइप के क्वेश्चंस के बेसिस पे हम जो हमारी एक्सरसाइज है वो सॉल्व करेंगे इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. टिल देन आई एम टेकिंग योर लीव. ओके, सो वी विल मीट इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर, सेम टाइम सेम प्लेस एंड विद द सेम बुक इन आवर हैंड्स. सो बाय बाय, टेक केयर एंड डू द होमवर्क. ओके, बाय.